Yo, what's good? So, I'm packed up and I'm about to go get my boy Owen. So, let's see how this trip goes. I know I've done a lot of trips this past month, so we'll see how this one goes. I'm sure it'll be fine though. Say what's up for the vlog.
That's one of the hardest things I've ever done.
Really?
Say goodbye.
It's so stupid.
Yo, so we are in like Newland or something, I can't remember what it's called, South Carolina right now. You mind? Mr. Owen can't get his phone right, but yeah, we're just filling up on gas real quick. This man wanted to go to Chick-fil-A so bad, and it was at a college like inside, so we of course couldn't go, but you know, you live and you learn.
Inside a local school.
All right, so we just stopped at a rest station, rest stop somewhere, maybe about 60 some miles from Savannah, still South Carolina. Oh, it's awful hot in here. Mr. Owen, he's been sleeping. Let the people know what you thought.
I was gonna die.
When did it like wake you up when I had pulled in?
When you ran into the tree.
Yeah, the tree.
The plum tree.
He jumped. I hadn't even got pulled all the way in the parking spot yet, and he jumped. I was waiting on it. I was expecting it to be sooner than that. But alrighty, well, we've got another 300 and some miles before we get to Orlando. 341. So let's get it. Like the cool blue light. Like the cool blue light.
Finally,
I've got axle damage now.
Sorry.
We can't go anywhere.
Just for reach out. I'll be the manpower strut spring thingy. Okay.
All right.
Move the strut again.
We are on rest stop number two. Doesn't seem like we've made a dent, but we have. We got 3 hours and 21 minutes to Orlando. Yeah, so we'll see how that goes.
Yeah, I'm just kidding.
That's $1.25. You ready?
Yes.
So this is how you get through tolls in Florida.
So just right. Straight down?
Well, break it first. Break it. Now, pull the ring around it out.
Like this?
Just pick it up. Ugh. Do like this. There oh, you okay, go. Okay. Ah, you dropped it.
Yep. There you go, okay.
Now just slam it straight down.
That's so cool.
Mayo, it's like a bit of like a tang and like mayo, and then we have eel sauce, which is like salty sweet. What else? So we got sriracha as well.
I'll try it.
Yeah, I'll get some sriracha. Yeah, thank you. DJ Khaled, bring out the whole ocean. And what is this?
Chicken is so good.
Give me a video right here, eating with Ricky, just for old time's sake. I use this for the Spotify canvas for some song one day.
Oh no!
I'm gonna be famous.
Alright,
that's good. Enjoy, okay?
Yeah.
Then die. Need more sauce, I got me.
Okay. We are finally here, and it took forever, almost to the Airbnb, literally just a few minutes.
Yo, what's going on, everybody? So I am currently on the way, probably to like the Trader Joe's or something. It's pretty crazy. Pretty crazy how everything is over here. We really didn't get in till real late last night, so we didn't see everything. But yeah, it's pretty wild. Yeah, so let's see how this trip to Trader Joe's is about to go. Alrighty, so I got out of Trader Joe's. It was all right. You know, I don't know. Prices were a little bit higher on a few different things than most places, but it wasn't, you know, overall too bad. But yeah, we are just gonna go back to the Airbnb now and kind of get ready for day one of the conference. It's hot. It is 93 degrees right now. And yeah. So we are getting here. Here's Mr. Owen today. We are walking up right now. Let's see how things go. How are you feeling so far?
Fantastic.
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 wrapping up thoughts for day one. So pretty much all we did was just check in, and it was just networking. It was pretty crazy. I think I met about 12 to 15 people total. Met another producer, that was real cool. Met him. I met a manager for a cool group. I can't think of the name of the group right now. And I met some guy who used to be a rapper in the UK in the 90s. So that's awesome. So right now, I'm just kind of chilling on the boardwalk. Just gonna go down by the beach. Day two, how we feeling, Owen?
Good.
Who are you most excited to see today?
Pat. Yep, what time is it?
It is time for us to get in there. It is 8:18. We needed to be here 30 minutes ago. I like the PA and the lighting rig.
So when you do finance the next restaurant, do it with this pen as
you can. That's what
you say, huh?
Great.
Right. You and I both.
Yes.
Or a four, does it come up to me? Does it not to me? Do I use a triage? You can kind of, I don't think you have that big of a business here.
Oh my gosh, dude, we're getting destroyed out here. Oh my gosh, shoo, it's crazy. Okay, so we are currently walking through the rain from a restaurant.
Let me tell you something about life, CJ's audience. You have to choose your canes. So I chose the pain of going through rain, made that sacrifice for food, because I would rather not have the pain of being hungry. So choose your pains in life.
I don't know that I can co-sign that. We were in torrential downpours and vehicle flashing us. But we finished up the second session. The third starts at 7 o'clock, goes to 9. It's been a pretty good day. I've enjoyed it. All right, here's what we got. Was it worth the walk in the rain, Owen? I don't know.
And they will not be wanting to be around with me too long. But then some of them want that and are that, and they're going to be that for you as well.
All right. So, how do we feel about the last session today?
Fantastic.
fantastic. Definitely, it was only 2 hours, so it was a little bit better than the 4 hours. But, you know, it was interesting for sure, and there's some valuable stuff. But I personally like the first one a little bit better. So, yeah, right now we're just walking back to the parking garage. But, yeah, I'd say all in all, it was a really good day. What would you rate it? 10 out of 5? Out of 1. 10 out of 1. That's good to hear.
Started working on this.
Wow.
And it was phase one, phase two, phase three, phase four, phase five. No, we gotta fix it, we gotta do this, we gotta do that. Constantly going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, until we finally got this. So, if you don't mind coming, don't take it off yet, because I want them to see when all of it come. I want to see the audience react first, then you see it. If you don't mind looking this way first.
Okay,
go ahead, take it down.
I can start crying.
Take it down, you cannot put it all down, go for it. Put it all down, yeah. Go for before I tell Tom to come in. Okay, hang on. Okay, Tom, why don't you look at this?
Am I good?
Yes. Tom, if you like this.
Oh, man.
So, can I explain? This is obviously family. We know what game this is. This is you, all your lame rings are here. You, draft 199, Michigan. Your mom, your dad, you, your kid. We created this Mount Rushmore with yourself, Michael, Tiger Woods, Messi, and then we got the Tampa side. All of this gift for you. So when you look at this, it reminds you of what you've done with the first half of your life. And wow. This is hopefully.
And how often you're willing to wake up every day and make the choices that are going to fulfill you and bring you the joy that you're looking for. So this is a great step in the journey. It's an honor to be with you guys, and hopefully we can do it again sometime. Thank you.
I appreciate the love more than you guys know, bro. I love, you have no idea how many, I know you guys are out there, people just showing me love. Thank you. There's one right there. Thank you. I love you guys. But some of you guys picked the worst time and place to show me love. Where's the Indian dude that I was in the bathroom right now? Trying to take a piss. There he is right there. Look. Bro, I'm peeing. And he's like, bitch.
What's your name?
Charlotte, like, hi. Now, you see this, and you're like, okay, look at guy. And then this, right? Like, look at this woman, like, and I have an ass, but it's not there. Any Armenians in the house?
Huge. He had the zipper below, no undershirt. The zipper, that chest hair flying everywhere. Bro, the zipper was hanging on to your dear life. If the zipper could speak, the zipper would go, ah! If it had dialogue, it would. And bro, I looked close, like the sun from the window hit his neck, and I saw like he had a gold chain with a medallion with Jesus on the cross. But Jesus was so far back in the air, he's like. Oh, we're gonna rip Jesus off. Like, Jesus, go! Run! White people love giving direction. They know, they've been up all night on freaking Google Earth. They know, they study the planet. Right? And you know how I love white people? White people would drop whatever the hell they're doing to give you directions. And their life doesn't matter anymore. It's about you and where the hell you're going. I was in Glendale, California, bro. Right? I was trying to get to Woodman. Exit. Burbank. Pull over. It's a white guy walking with this baby, bro. Newborn. The lady was pulling the, pushing the carriage. Just, the baby was still wet. It's brand new, bro. I pulled up and I was like, excuse me, sir. Looking for Woodman. You want to get to Woodman? He looked like he won money. He was like, Woodman? Yeah, honey. He's like, oh, they, what you're going to want to do. They always say that. Five useless words. What you're going to want to do. He was in my car. He was like, come here. And his wife was trying to get involved because she's white. He's like, honey, I got it. Thank you. Women, all right. And they're very precise. You're going to go 0.5 miles that way. Then you're going to want to go east. And I was like, Magellan, I don't have a compass in the car. Left or right? And white people always like to do a little challenge, like a monkey wrench. She was like, all right, you're going to come go fork in the road.
This is the final day, the morning of the final day. How'd you feel about yesterday, Tom Brady?
Awesome.
Whole lot of information. Really busy. Definitely learned a lot.
Awesome.
Yeah, didn't do a lot of updates pretty much yesterday after the conference. We were going to go back to the Airbnb, but the train tracks we have to cross had a train across and stopped. So we couldn't get across. We just chilled out, went to this restaurant by the beach, and then pretty much came back and a bit of a storm hit. So that's pretty much how everything went. What are you looking forward to today in here with Mike Tyson?
I feel like the way that they lined everything up with all the speakers, like we're about to get like some hype on the way out.
Some hype. Yeah. Well, noon, man.
And that guy's been in his car.
Awesome.
To the left.
It's hard to even explain, it's so complex. beautiful heart. But if he's mad at you, he wants to kill everybody, your family, your cousin, and screaming. And he had such a personality, smart intellect. That's what I wanted to say about Tupac. Extremely intellectual. He act like a crazy man. In fact, extremely intellectual. His parts, you'll never believe it.
You said he was just a Gemini. Is that what you just said?
He's a Gemini.
Yeah. By the way, do you know famous Geminis? You guys, Tupac was a Gemini. Biggie was a Gemini.
Yeah.
Marilyn Monroe, John F. Kennedy, Brad Pitt, Angelina Jolie, a bunch of these guys were Geminis.
Wow, these people got different all these personalities, right? God, okay?
What is your reason?
I'm a Cancer. Cancer got emotional issues. Cause they gotta analyze things. Like, somebody might say something to them. And then when you go home, I say, did he diss me?
Hey, Mike, thanks a lot for the opportunity. So we all see that you shared a special relationship with us. How did his teachings not only shape you as a boxer, but also as a man? And are there any life lessons from him that you still carry with you today?
Just
an
interesting guy. The way I, you guys say, reinvent myself, it's just that I want to be up on anybody on the planet. I want you to be down. And that's just what it's all about. Wanting to get the best out of yourself. Not competing with anyone else but you. And that's how we improve as a person. Improving ourselves to an emotional level. And sometimes you can feel superior, but it's superior in a good way because we should be bound up and everybody would be superior in that same level because that's what it's all about, everybody being equal. Some people have.
He's a state senator, I believe. He was a state senator for Arkansas. He was a pastor 12 years and he's now running for mayor. Go for it.
All right.
Can I say before I ask my question, I understand why we have security here, but it's just fun to think about that there's not a grown-ass man in this room that can do anything to you. But here's my question. I always like to hear from successful people how they deal with something that's a different level of pain. There's a lot of people in this room that can bring pain to me, but betrayal has to do with proximity. Only people close to me can betray me. And I want to know from a successful individual how you dealt with betrayal in your life. Because ultimately hurt people, and that's something that we have to get beyond is betrayal. We will all experience it at some point in our lives. So is there a moment in your life that you can talk to us about how you dealt with betrayal in someone close to you?
No. I always looked at how I betrayed myself to put myself in that situation. I just don't look at life as everybody's picking on me and why you did that to me and I'm black, I can't do shit. I don't live my life like that. I don't live my life like that. I live my life that I can, as far as my eyes can see, I'm superior.
I'm Mike the Champ, the greatest
the way you stepped into a ring, the mindset you had, the way you would look at your opponent in the eyes, and it was like freaking just terrifying. And I know the guys, they were trying to act all bad, but just you had that killer look in your eye. But I loved you, how you would go in there with the mindset and the discipline, and whatever you had to do, you made no excuses, you made it happen. I loved you in the hangover. We watched that last night, beating the guys where you knocked out Allen. Best scene ever. It was amazing. But my question is this. When you said in the beginning, a good fighter has to be diligent, committed, doing what you hate to do, but doing it like you love it, in your life, what is the thing that you hated the most to do, but forced yourself to do it?
I love ice cream, right? I'll buy the ice cream, put it in the freezer, and not touch it. But I'm very tempted to do it.
You have it in the fridge.
Yeah.
You look at it, and you touch it.
Exactly. It's whatever is about depriving yourself. By depriving yourself, and then time to reward yourself. First, you have to deprive yourself of all pleasures. That's who I was. I didn't want nothing until I got something. When I said something, I didn't cry.
You could give him some chant message or something.
Okay. We were talking about
his name is Ramon.
Ramon, this is Mike Tyson, and we're among 3,000 friends here. We all like to give you our biggest respect.
Found the belt of Roberto Duran signed. Would have known it there to give to you as a gift for you coming out here to the World Conference. Again, for the third time coming up, and I hope you enjoyed this year.
Let's see how it sounds.
All right, let's see. I'm trying to secure the cell phone here. Thank you.
Zevia. It's that drink you can get at like
Kroger. That's kind of what it reminds me of.
Okay, the only guy not in it is now in it.
What books are you talking about here?
So, Alex Ramosi, $100 million leads, $100 million offers. They will change your life, change your business, and will make you rich as.
Awesome. All right, so we just got out of lunch and it absolutely went crazy. We were kind of wanting to get home, you know, ASAP, but we had about six others with us. No, we had five others with us, seven total. And then a like group of like four more people showed up and there was already another group of people from the conference there. And everybody just leaked up and like, we've got this massive picture of everybody. So, but yeah, here's to a solid 12, 13 hours of driving. So it is 7:07 a.m. I just dropped Owen off and yeah, I've officially been up for 24 hours on 5 hours of sleep. So that's not been the best, but yeah, we've still got an hour to go home and yeah, we'll touch back later.